Senator Franklin Drilon says the possibility of him taking the Senate presidency is not yet certain at this time. But Drilon admits his role as Team Pinoy's campaign manager and the victory of 19 Pinoy senatorial candidates give him the edge over other contenders.
We have been there before, been there, done that, as they say. We can help in the president's agenda if the 13, the majority in the Senate, would feel that we can deliver and deliver the mandate that we got in the last election, then I'm willing to serve. I will not be coy about it, but to say that in the bag, no. We have to talk to each senator, find out what are their preferences, and judge.
You're just going to talk about preferences of committees, sir.
We have also to we have also to figure out, their capabilities and how well they would mesh with their constituencies in that particular field. So a lot of things would have to happen, and until the fat lady sings, the game is not over.
Drilon adds, once the 16th Congress opens sessions in July 22, the president's allies in the Senate will work on amending the charter of the autonomous region of Muslim Mindanao, repair loopholes in the fiscal incentive program, and improve the mining law.
The president will have a better chance of pushing his legislative agenda, because there are a number of difficult items that I can foresee. For one, we have to amend the charter of the Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao to conform with the framework agreement. How that will come out, how the framework agreement will come out with the annexes, we still do not know, and how easy or how tough it will be in the Senate to adhere to that framework agreement, nobody knows. Number two, for years we have been trying to fix our fiscal incentive program in order that it can be more equitable and less subject to abuse, because we see incentives all over the place. Some already call it a loophole, and so we must work on that. Also, we have to work on the mining law and see what kind of resource sharing we could come up with
a more equitable one.
Yes, a more equitable one, so that the government and the people would have their own equitable share of the resources.
Okay.
You're
talking about the priority, probably measures, no? Because that's been talked about, the framework agreement.
That's right. And Pinky, this was also discussed in the present. This was discussed before in the LEDAC. That many of this, like the mining law, the rationalization of the fiscal incentive.
Drilon stresses the Senate will not likely tackle any amendments to the Constitution because President Aquino could be perceived as wanting to extend his term beyond 2016.
When you debate on the chancha, your attention is diverted, to that very critical political exercise, and you tend to neglect what like these measures that we mentioned. Number two, there is always that doubt that when you touch chacha on the last 3 years of the sitting president, there's always that doubt that they want to stay extension of term. And the president, I tell you, has always indicated he keeps on counting the number of days remaining in his term, like his mother. So I can believe him that he doesn't want any term sharing, but people's mind and politicians' mind and media's mind is very fertile.